Hi everybody, this is Nick Miller from miniquadclub.com, and I'm here today to talk about the Skypak FPV backpack from fpvbackpack.com. You can see it right here. I've been using this bag for about a month now. It's been my daily commute bag, meaning that I've taken all my stuff with me every day to work with this. Throw it in the back seat of my car, take it out of the field, toss it on the ground, use it as a workstation. I've tossed it on park benches, picnic tables, anything you can imagine this bag's been through so far. And I gotta say, it's been holding up really, really well. So let me give you guys a brief overview here. So this is obviously the top of it. You can tell it's got a hard reinforced top. It also has some pre-reinforced sides. This top compartment is actually built to hold to multiple quads. So it'll hold up to a 450 quad if you have just one large quad. It can also hold a 380 and a 280 side by side. In my case, which you're about to see, it'll hold two 225s and actually holds another one vertically if you'd like to, and actually probably could hold four minis in here depending on how you arranged it. So let me open up the top here. So all right, so as you can see now inside, here's what the inside compartment looks like. The top of it is hard, and as like I said before, it has Velcro on the top of it. You can see in here that these pylons, it comes with six of them. I've used four of them. The bottom has some Velcro lining that these pop into, and they also lock into the top. And as you can see, it holds my MQC1 frames just fine. Kind of done flying, I drop them in there. Same thing with my backup. Kind of tuck it in there, and that's kind of, you know, how that compartment works. These are completely customizable, which is great. You could, you know, lay one on its side here and stack a third quad. If you had three smaller ones, that's what I'm going to be doing with my third. I'll be able to lay it across all those by putting one of the blocks here vertically and use that Z axis right here, which was a good recommendation for one of the club members. So, you know, I'll be able to hold three, but like I said, it'll hold a 450. It'll hold a TBS. I saw someone have a nice TBS in it, which I'll try to throw a picture in there too. So it's got a lot of storage options, and for someone who's going to be flying all day like me or going to a race or an event, you know, this is great because you can hold quite a few different quads. So that's kind of how the top compartment's laid out. Let me close it back up here, and I'll show you the undercom side. Now, the cool thing is that I've carried this thing around for a while now, and I've also, you know, had my quads in it, and the quads don't move around a lot once you zip this thing up. So here's the inside. On this side of the bag, there's actually a laptop sleeve. You can actually store your laptop in here, which is pretty nice. And then you can see here, there's a huge assortment of adjustable pockets and dividers. So let me show you what I have in this bag. So obviously there's my two quads in there right now. I have a towel for FPV because I get sweaty in the summer and sometimes in the winter. So there's a towel. I have all my HD cams in here. So I have two, I got a Mobius Standard, a Mobius Wide. I have a Foxeer Legend, I have a Yee, and I have a Run Cam all in one pocket. So all my HD cams are in there. I have, in this pocket, I have all my warm-up batteries. There's five 1400 LiPos in there, two Fat Shark batteries, and in this pocket, I have my actual batteries I use for racing and for acro. So I have a bunch of a Rebel 1300s. There's five of them in there. So there's 10 batteries between these two. Actually 12 with the two Fat Sharks. In this pocket, I have divided all my antennas. So I have an SPW Plus from SpecUAV. I got a set of Fat Sharks, and I got a three-turn helical. All again in this one pocket here. In this big pocket here, as you can see, I have some amazing props from my lovable sponsor, GemFan. These are my favorite. These are the big old 5045 bullnose. Tons of sets in here, just in that pocket. I have my Tyrannus sitting up in there.
Welcome to Tyrannus.
Boom. You know, fits in there perfectly, very actually well protected. I think perfectly sized because everything in here is adjustable. You can actually see when I move it out of here that the bottom of this is Velcro, and these are bottom to both Velcro, and then the sides. So all this is fully adjustable. Looking up here, I have Predator V2s for ride-alongs. Dominator V2s for me. Mini toolkit. Mini FPV monitor and ground station setup. Uno. And I have the 3D printed accessories for the bag, which help you lean the bag in and become a tripod. And I have the actual extension that is the tripod right here, and all in this bag. And so, you know, for the guy that wants to go to the field with everything in one bag and wants to, you know, take it to work every day and really have everything they need to be able to get around with basically your mobile workstation, your mobile home away from home, so to speak, this is by far the most customizable option that I've run across so far. The construction of it is really sturdy. You can actually sit on it when it's closed if you're under 180 pounds. So I'm not sitting on mine anytime soon. But that being said, you know, you can pack a lot of weight on this. It's not gonna buckle or go anywhere. These are very, very sturdy. They feel like they're like plastic or plexiglass or something. They're very, very sturdy. Don't feel like they're gonna crush. Again, the sides of this and the four sides and the top, extremely crush proof. And once you stack this together and zip it up, what you end up with is a backpack that really holds everything you could possibly want it to hold, to take to the field with you. The cool thing is that it replaced myself carrying a couple different bags. I had a couple of smaller bags. I also had a hard shell toolbox that I carried with me. And for all intents and purposes, this has been my daily way to carry all my stuff. So I think if you're the kind of guy that travels a lot, this is also, maybe mention this while I remember, if you travel a lot, this actually will be able to be taken on an airplane with you as a carry-on, and that's pretty important since all the lipos have to be a carry-on. You can't check any of the lipos in your luggage. So, you know, if you're traveling a lot with your quads, especially for a lot of you guys that are racing, a lot of my team guys, you know, this is a great thing to have because you can literally have everything of high value on your person the whole entire time of the trip. I don't have to worry about losing anything in your luggage or anything getting crushed. You can take this on the plane with you, throw it in the check above you or below you, you know, and you'll have it. And so really cool to be, you know, the right size for that. And again, once you, you know, seal this guy up, you know, I've literally thrown it into my car and not had any problems. So I think for the person that travels a lot, especially with plane rides, things like that, this thing's great for that. I think for the person that, you know, really needs to take everything with them when they go to the field for a full day of flying or a full day at an event, it's also great for that. So right now, you know, it's definitely my go-to bag. And, you know, there's a lot of other good products out there, and I'll be reviewing some of those. But at the same time, you know, for the guy that really, you know, wants to take everything, including the kitchen sink with them, you really can't beat the Skypak. So check it out online. Again, it's fpvbackpack.com. And thanks a lot for tuning in. Plenty more to come. MQC for life.